It's not uncommon when patients come to medical attention, particularly at Bateman Horne Center, where we are familiar with this illness, that their lives have come crashing down around them. This illness is characterized by exhaustion and low stamina, low energy reserves, increased symptoms from trying to do cognitive and physical tasks, poor sleep, pain, aches and pains, brain fog, dizziness, and many symptoms that are just disabling and make it very difficult to carry out normal activities.
Before I had ME, I ran 2 marathons in six days from Boston to Big Sur. And now with ME, if I walk a mile, I have to recover for a day.
This is an illness of suffering, of dramatically limited capabilities to do almost everything, to think, to walk, to exercise, to sit and to watch TV or work on the computer. Almost all of those things are impacted in some way by this illness, and the stamina to do those things is very, very limited.
So my friends who are in college spend around like 4 hours a day in their classes. But for me, I can really only do like an hour max for my schoolwork on a day. And that's even with it being broken into 15-minute segments like throughout my day.
It's almost impossible for the majority of people with ME/CFS to work a full-time job in our work-heavy culture and still have anything left over for even basic functions. So many people who do maintain work, even if it's for a short period of time, they'll go into work, come home, and just a patient yesterday told me, he gets home and he's so tired, so incapable, that he can't even prepare a meal and eat dinner.
Starting in the mid-90s, I spent anywhere between 10 and 16 hours a day in bed. It wasn't that I didn't want to get up and do things. It was that I couldn't.
When someone says, usually it's a patient who says to me, my doctor says he doesn't believe in this, or this isn't real. Now my response is just a smile or a laugh, because the science supporting the underpinnings of the pathology of ME/CFS is huge. There are thousands and thousands of published papers looking at the science, the immunology, the virology, the metabolomics, and that, you know, what's happening at the cellular level, what's happening with cytokines. The problem is that the science hasn't translated to the clinicians. So we have this gulf, and that has been the mission of BHC since the time we started, to reach across this ignorance, this gulf of ignorance, and take the science to the clinicians so that they can then apply that to patient care and provide better patient care.
I've had CFS, ME/CFS, since I was about 14, and I'm 66, so it's been a lifetime.
We want to make sure that the whole world understands what this illness is, knows how to diagnose it, knows how to treat these people suffering from this with dignity, and can actually provide meaningful clinical care. And from that, hopefully, more and more dollars will pour into research all across the world so that we can ultimately find a cure for this devastating illness.
The hardest part of having ME/CFS has been discovering my value in a world that values productivity, what you can do, how much money you can make, providing for your family. And ME/CFS has taken those things from me.
We formed Bateman Horne Center, a nonprofit clinic and research center, specifically because it's very difficult to do, to make progress, to take time, and to do research without in a clinical setting. Our clinic basically runs at a break-even level, if the best we can do to be efficient. So the funds we get at BHC enable our physicians to spend more time with patients, to provide educational materials for patients, to develop and provide educational materials to physicians. And we're a lean, very productive nonprofit. And most of what we do goes right into the kind of materials that make an immediate difference.
When I walked into Dr. Bateman's office and every single person there offered me hope, it was like giving me my future. Dr. Bateman and all the people that work with her are some of the only people on the planet that see us. If you can give anything to Dr. Bateman, you're giving hope.
If you're a potential donor, I hope you will consider Bateman Horne Center. We have so much to do, and we have hundreds and hundreds of patients who need our help. And for every dollar we get, we can see more patients in the clinic, enroll more patients in research, and create educational materials that will transform the way patients are taken care of in primary care and by their specialists.
My life is much richer because of Bateman Horne Center, and I can never say thank you enough.